The National Women's Hockey League hosted its All-Star game today at the Wells new practice rink in St. Paul, despite the fact that Minnesota doesn't have an NWHL team, at least not yet. David McCoy tells us about the state of hockey's place in the spotlight today and what the future might hold for women's professional hockey in Minnesota.
Well, it's very exciting for professional women's hockey to come to Minnesota.
The All-Stars of the NWHL here in Minnesota. And Minnesota in the All-Star game. Both teams stocked with a player from the Minnesota Whitecaps, the local semi-pro team that plays a schedule against Minnesota colleges. Both teams coached by a Minnesota women's hockey legend.
To give them the credit that they deserve. They've been around for 14 years and have done so much for the women's game.
And the house was packed.
This is our big event of the year. Outside of our playoffs, like, this is it.
The NWHL is the first women's pro hockey league to pay its players. It's in its third season. It launched as a regional league in the Northeast. Its original four franchises in New York, Connecticut, Boston, and Buffalo. But this is part of its effort to branch out.
Last year we were fortunate enough to partner with the Pittsburgh Penguins, bring our All-Star game out to Pittsburgh, and in 1 month alone, in the month of February, our fan base grew 15% just by going out of our traditional market. So there's definitely a larger fan base than just the Northeast for women's hockey, and we want to tap into it.
If there was a place to tap into, Minnesota would be it, for a myriad reasons.
Minnesota is obviously a really great hockey market. I mean, it's the state of hockey. I can definitely rattle off all the statistics that make this state a no-brainer for us to consider expanding to.
And the Whitecaps offer a ready-made team already here.
I think this is a great opportunity for a conversation to take place between the NWHL and the Whitecaps, and the Minnesota Wild are involved in those conversations as well. So, you know, we're hopeful that something eventually might be able to work out, but this is a good step to just get to know each other a little bit better and see where it goes.
The biggest hurdle remains the travel. You can't bus to Minnesota like you can around the Northeast. And for the moment, that makes expansion here untenable. But both parties are actively seeking ways to make it possible. Perhaps today was the start of something.
What I think is really cool is that people in Minnesota have come out this weekend to support women's hockey, even though there isn't a Minnesota team in this league yet. I think that support is really important, especially for the NWHL to see that there are a lot of women's hockey fans in Minnesota.
David McCoy, WCCO 4 Sports.